you know, oh, Kobe, oh, this or that. And I'm just thinking, like, he really didn't give a fuck about black women. So I was actually kind of surprised that, you know, there was all these posts flying up on social media and whatever. And I do think it's quite interesting. But again, you know, it's easy, like I said, to tap into the emotions of so-called black American women in particular. Now, I took a few notes on this because the thing is, I've been telling you guys since I've been on social media, so that's probably been like, it's 2020 now, so it's been about 6 years that I've been saying things are going to escalate, things are going to get worse. Nobody is exempt from just the, you know, the vengeance that the dark mother in particular brings upon people. You know, if you live your life and carry out your life in a certain way to get certain things in return, then you're gonna get it. And these days, you're gonna get it quick. There's no waiting period any longer for the bullshit that people receive, due to the things that they do, and you know, just acts that they carry out. So I wrote a few notes here. And I just, like I said, I think it's interesting how people are quick to mourn celebrities just based on the fact that they're on national television or international television. And it's like nobody really looks at the things that the people do. It's just all like, oh, you know, this person was a celebrity and, you know, they dribbled a ball well. So, you know, I feel so bad about, you know, just what happened and yada, yada, yada. And you know, my thing is, a lot of people are just wasting time with this faux sympathy type of thing. And you know, I think it's all bullshit. I think a lot of the people are supposed to know RIP, you know, not everybody, but I do think a good number of people are like, it's all bullshit to me. Now, another thing that I wanted to stress was, because this is the stuff that people don't think about, you know, this is the stuff that people want to sweep under the rug. People like sweeping bullshit under the rug, especially in the United States of America. So, my thing is, you know, this man was accused of rape back in 2003, okay? Anally raping a woman who worked at a girl, I think she was 19, who worked at a hotel. I'm like, and of course, you know, these celebrities have enough money to pay people off and, you know, to get stuff taken off their records and whatever else and all this type of stuff. But the whole point is that shit happened. And, you know, but if you have money, you can, oh, well, let's just sweep it under the rug and let's just, if you're a celebrity, oh, well, they're, you know, they dribble the ball well. So what else, whatever other things they do, we don't give a fuck, right? People take, you know, dignity and things of that nature out of the equation when it comes to celebrities. It's like they put these celebrities on this god status of they can do nothing wrong, basically. So it's quite interesting that a lot of women I've seen, you know, a lot of women who especially talk about, you know, just how the rates at which women are being raped and abused and things like that, but they're over here talking about RIP Kobe. So it's just interesting the hypocrisy that I see from certain individuals. And you know, he was obviously married. He had over 100 affairs. So that's another thing. He definitely, you know, regarding the spiritual and the natural aspect of it, he did not understand the first law of nature, which is the law of self-preservation. And we can see that by looking at his family. You know, I wouldn't really say he was an ally of indigenous women, of so-called black women in particular. And you know, these are most of the women that I see online expressing the sympathy for him. So it's quite interesting. Did you honor the natural law of self-preservation? You know, it's a lot of fake people out here claiming to be this and that, you know, who conveniently ignore certain aspects of things. And it's like, it doesn't matter who you're related to, the truth is the truth. It doesn't matter who you like, the truth is the truth, regardless, period. So that's something else I wanted to say, you know, and the answer to those questions is no. You know, he didn't do those things. He didn't respect women. You know, he didn't adhere to the law of self-preservation. And so he cut his life short. And whatever way in which his life was cut short in the mundane world is whatever way it was. But his life was already cut short spiritually a long time ago. So that's the thing that a lot of people are failing to understand. And it's quite interesting because I'm like, you know, all these witches and whatever and claiming to be this and that, but y'all don't get this. So it's quite funny. But that type of energy will extend to your offspring. So you got to be careful how you carry yourself, what you do, because that will extend to your offspring. And we saw that happen in this case. And, you know, that's just the raw truth about it. You know, there are many ways in which people cut their lives short. There's the physical way. There is the spiritual way, you know, and, you know, some people say karma, whatever people want to call it, you know, so it's just like you have to watch what you do and, you know, who you do it to. You really do. So, you know, and he didn't. He cut his life short. And so what I wanted to say is that women, you all need to preserve your empathy and sympathy for people who are worth it, for people who matter. Stop falling for all this stuff on television that you're seeing. Stop falling for people based on how much money they have, how much fame they have, and then bitching and complaining when you end up getting abused and whatever because you decided to fall for some shit for a mundane reason. Okay, so we're going to talk about women are goddesses and this and that. Well, I'm going to need for y'all to step into your goddesshood and start carrying yourself like it and understand what comes along with that.
True peace, this is Tarnu Net, and I will be elaborating on what the young lady was speaking about using the 9-book count 4, the 9 new moon guides, and the nature book 2, commandment laws of nature. It'll be on race mixing and interracial marriages and the consequences. Okay, I'm just going to break down a little bit what the new moon guides consist of. They're in 9-book count 4. I will leave the information. Now, let me begin. The 9 new moon guides are those word formulas of motivation and activation which propel new moons to success, individually and as a race. In other words, any new moon who has the durability and intelligence to adhere to the word formulas called the 9 new moon guides will survive through the ages and be successful. Ethiopian and new moon mean the same. A new moon is a woolly-haired Ethiopian. So when we state new moon, we mean a person or person with genuinely woolly hair, meaning genuinely kinky hair. Here is number 1 of the 9 new moon guides. I promise to preserve self at all times to the best of my knowledge, wisdom, understanding, and ability. Here is a brief explanation of number 1 of the 9 guides. Complete self is not just one individual. Complete self is all those of a kind, all people of the same race are one being. A race is one being with many parts, and those parts are the individuals of that race. So the promise to preserve self is a promise to protect self and kind in every possible and practical way. Number 2 of the 9 new moon guides reads like this. I promise to have sexual relations with no one but the opposite sex of my own kind. This is a brief explanation of number 2 of the 9 new moon guides. This restriction is also a part of self-preservation, and self-preservation is the first law of nature, as the young lady stated previously in my video. Eternal life is the continuous procreation with the opposite sex of your own kind. Therefore, it is very desirous to have a son among the offspring of a family. Well, we heard Kobe wanted a son. Nature wasn't allowing that to happen. His offspring also died in that crash. Nature's laws are supreme. I can't say that enough. Now we're going to look at the commandment laws of nature. Commandment law number 30. Interracial marriage is racial genocide. Forbidden. The same way each time that conditions are the same. Now when we hear the same way that each time conditions are the same, that means that absolute nature is constant, consistent, and standard in the application of its laws and penalties. It's serious. It is very selfish for two people to think only of themselves and not consider what disservice and problems they may create along with their procreation of their children in an interracial marriage or relationship. And one of those disservices and problems is genocide of the races involved, particularly from the standpoint of the Ethiopian race with the kingly hair, which makes its members of mixture easily distinguishable, usually. Interracial mixing sexually is an assault on the Ethiopian race, especially because our race had to absolve the results of miscegenation, while the Caucasian race refuses to accept racial mixtures, particularly those from the Ethiopian race side of humanity. And this fact means that one-sided genocide for the African race, and this is neither tolerable nor desirable to intelligent members of the Ethiopian race who are trying to restore pride and promise, respect and dignity, recognition and integrity to the African race, also called the black race. Okay, pay attention to this part right here. One race does not have to only physically kill off members of another race in order to commit genocide. It can also sexually dump on another race and help cause genocide of that race. And note that this kind of genocide is pleasurable and much less noteworthy. And this is part of the trick and deception for destruction of the oppressed race. Let it be remembered always and let it be known. This is commandment law number 4, and I see it fits the topic at hand. Avoid negative temptation by keeping away from it or departing from its presence. The same way each time that conditions are the same. The same way each time that conditions are the same. Negative temptation is a powerful and diabolical force, and the best way to keep from being trapped by it is to keep away from it, or if you suddenly find yourself in the presence of it, depart from it immediately. Otherwise, you might very well become a victim of it. Temptation is the opportunity to do something you should not do or be attracted to, a person or thing you should not be attracted to. To disobey the temptation commandment is to violate laws of nature. Let it be remembered always and let it be known. Listen and reason. I will repeat and emphasize, if one does not adhere to the commandment laws of nature, he or she has transgressed, violated the laws of nature, and will eventually, if not immediately, experience the negative results of the violation. Thank you. nature's laws apply to everyone, not just a selected few. And nature's laws also supersede mankind's laws. True mental cosmic peace. This is Tar Nunet, Bunan Nupu, and I am a proud member of the Ethiopian race.